Good morning, student. Today we will discuss about doping. Doping means the use of banned performance enhancing drugs in sports. Or we can say doping means the use of prohibited substance or methods in sports to improve the performance. Okay, doping means use of banned performance enhancing drugs in sports. Or we can say use of banned performance enhancing sports. Or we can say use of prohibited substance. Methods in sports. So this is about the doping. Doping means the use of banned performance enhancing drugs in sports or use of prohibited substance, metals of blood to improve the performance. Doping is banned
by IOC. Okay, doping, it is banned by IOC. IOC means International Olympic Committee. IOC has banned doping because IOC want dope free clean sports. You want to give equal opportunity for all players, and drugs, it is also harmful for the health of the athletes. Therefore, doping is banned in the sport. In international labels, doping is banned by the International Olympic Committee. In international level, World Anti-Doping Agency. Okay, WADA means World Anti-Doping Agency. World Anti-Doping Agency, he checked that whether the athletes has taken drugs or not. And in national levels, National Anti-Doping Agency, NADA, checked whether the player has taken drugs or not. So this is about the doping. Doping means the use of drugs or any substance or methods. Okay, use of drugs or blood product to improve the performance. Doping, it is banned by the IOC because IOC wants drug-free, clean sports, healthy sports. We want to give equal opportunity for all players. It affects the health of the player. And at international levels, World Anti-Doping Agency check whether the player has taken drugs or no. And in national levels, NADA, National Anti-Doping Agency check whether the player has taken drugs or no. And doping in sports are taken during the training. They take drugs during the training or in the competitions. There are various types of doping. The types of doping like drug administration, blood doping, and
anti-doping. Types of doping. Types of doping. There are three types of doping. First, drug drug administration. Second, blood doping. And third is gene doping. These are the three types of doping. Drug administration means the use of drugs like narcotics, stimulant, steroid, beta blocker, growth hormones, diuretics, etc. Drug administration means use of drugs like stimulant, narcotics, steroids, beta blocker, diuretics, okay? These are the some drugs which are used by the players during the competitions. As stimulant, it makes the player energetic, active, okay? And narcotics, it is a good painkiller. Narcotics, it is a good painkiller. Steroid, it is used for healing. Beta blocker, it helps to reduce blood pressures, it reduces heart rate, make the players relax, increase his concentration. Diuretics, it helps to eliminate fluid from the body, by which it helps to reduce weight, fast reducing the weight. Blood doping means increasing red blood cells. Blood doping, it is also known as erythropoieting. Blood doping, it is a process in which the red blood cells is administration. Blood doping, it is a process of increasing the red blood cells by blood transfusion. The extra red blood cells, by increasing the red blood cells, the hormones is increased, more oxygen reach to the working muscles, our endurance, strength will be improved, by which the performance of our players will be increased. And blood doping, it may be done by injecting him. This can be done by injecting extra red blood cells from the donor
or injecting on harvested blood. Before the competition, the blood is taken out, and during the competition, the blood is injected on taking the drugs to increase the red blood cells. So this is about the blood doping. Blood doping means increasing the red blood cells, and this red blood cells, it carry more oxygen, it carry more hormones, more oxygen. So blood doping, red blood cells, more blood, more oxygen will reach to the working muscles, by which the endurance, the performance will improve. The red blood cells will increase by injecting the red blood cell from the donor, or injecting on harvested blood, or using drugs. And gene doping means gene doping means the use of cells, gene, or modifying own genes to improve the performance. Okay, gene doping means the use of cells, gene, or modifying the gene to improve the performance. Usually, the sports females, they have muscular body, boy's body. Male boys, their body structure is different, etc. Due to doping. So these are the some types of doping. Okay, blood doping, drug administration, blood doping, and gene doping. Drug administration means use of drug. Blood doping means increasing the red blood cells, and gene doping means the use of cells, use of cell, gene, or modifying the gene. Let's discuss about some drug. First is estimulant. Estimulant. It is a chemicals which have a direct effect over the central nervous system. Okay, estimulant, it has a direct effect. Direct effect over the central nervous system and cardiovascular system. Estimulant, it has to reduce the fatigue. It increase heart rate and reduce the reaction time. Estimulant. Its side effect. Estimulant, it has to increase the endurance, speed. It make us player active, energetic. And the side effect of estimulant is aggressive behavior. Aggressive behavior, blurred vision, violent behavior, aggressiveness, irregular heartbeat, etc. So estimulant, direct effect estimulant has direct effect over central nervous system and cardiovascular system. Okay, estimulants, it has direct effect. It is a chemicals which has direct effect over the central nervous system and cardiovascular systems. It helps to reduce fatigue. Stimulant, it helps to reduce fatigue. It increase heart rate. Increase heart rate and reduce
reaction time. And reduce the reaction times. It is mainly it help to increase speed, endurance, etc. And side effect of stimulant is the person become aggressive. Violent behavior, blurred vision, reduced irregular heartbeat, which has direct effect over the central nervous system and cardiovascular systems. It stimulate and make the players energetic, active. It helps to reduce the fatigue of a person. It helps to increase speed, endurance of a person. It side effect. The side effect is aggressiveness, violent behavior, blurred vision, etc. It is mainly found in cough syrup, caffeine, muscular gel, etc. Next is narcotics. Narcotics, it is a good painkiller. Painkillers. They help to increase the endurance. Good painkillers remove fatigue, tiredness, okay, it helps to reduce the feeling of tiredness, reduce restlessness, etc. It increase endurance. Therefore, it is used in the game where endurance is required, like cycling, marathon running, etc. And side effect of narcotics is slow and sleepy. The player will become sleepy, slow and sleepy, loss of concentration. Loss of concentration, nausea, vomiting, etc. This is about the narcotics, and it is found in cough syrup, painkiller medicine, etc. So this is about the narcotics. Narcotics, it is a good painkiller. The player use to reduce their pain. It remove the fatigue, remove the feeling of tiredness, make the players rest, increase endurance. The endurance of a player increase. The side effect is slow and sleepy,
loss of concentration, nausea, vomiting. The players, they also addicted to the to these drugs, etc. Next is astrolabe. Astrolabe, it is used for fast healing. Fast healing. Rebuilding tissue. Okay, this is about the astrolabe. Astrolabe, it is used for healing. It is good healing. Used for healing, rebuilding of tissue, increase heart rate, blood circulation, increase blood circulation, increase blood circulation, reduce increase heart rate. Okay, it's helping increase heart rate, increase body temperatures, etc. This is about the astrolabe. Astrolabe, it is a chemicals, it is a strong chemicals which are used by the players for healing. It is used for fast healing, rebuilding of tissue, damaged tissue, increase blood circulations, heart rate, etc. Usually astrolabe are made from the animal sex organs. The side effect of astrolabe, the side effect of astrolabe is a heart attack, nausea. Heart attack, nausea, male voice in female, male body structures, infertility, infertility in women, it causes cancer. Cancer in liver, kidney, infertility in females, male voice in female, male body structures, muscular body, hypertension, aggressive behavior, uncontrolled motion, etc. Next is growth hormones. Okay, growth hormones, it is used for increasing the muscles, used for increasing the mass of muscle, increasing the size, mass of muscle, height. Height, size of the body, etc. These are the benefit of astrolabe. Benefit of growth hormones. Growth hormones, it is mainly used by the bodybuilders, weight lifters, etc. Okay, astrolabe. Growth hormones, it is used for increasing the muscle mass, mass of the muscle mass, size, height, etc. And used by the bodybuilders, weightlifters, thrower, etc. The side effect. A side effect is unbalanced height. Unbalanced height. Structures. Posture deformity. Posture deformity, etc. These are the side effects: unbalanced height and size of the body, posture deformity, bones may be defective, it may lead to overweight, etc. Next is beta blocker. Beta blocker, it is used to reduce the blood pressures, it has to reduce heart rate, body temperatures, relax the mass, of the muscle, it relax the muscle, etc. Used in those games where the concentration is required, like archery, shooting, etc. Its side effect, it is seen in the later days. And diuretics, it is used. It eliminates the fluid from the body. It is used in the game where weight is measured. By eliminating the fluid, it has to reduce the weight in a short period of time. It is used in the game like boxing, judo, wrestling, etc. where weight is measured. Its side effect, dehydration, malnutrition, fainting, natural appetite, weight loss, etc.